brother, so the bar is where I go. Me and my friends at the table doing shots, drinking. What's up guys, Stacked here with another video. In the video of today I like to talk about the Flip 4, a full review about it. It has been some time that I have been using this Bluetooth speaker and I'm very impressed with the overall quality of the speaker. But keep in mind, my review will also be based on the price that I paid for the product. So I paid about 80 euros for it, a new one, and normally it's around 100 euros, but it also has to do that I ordered from outside of Europe. So keep that in mind. But still, I think if you can get it for 100 euros or a little bit more, it's still a pretty decent speaker, but we're going more into all the details now. Let's start with the build quality. And the build quality is in different kind of range. So of course you have the outside of the build quality and that's very decent. So the fabric about the speaker looks and also feels very well. It's the same quality as the Charge 3. But the problem with, I would say the buttons, it's the same problem as with the Charge 3. If you have a very light color like me, so I have the mint color or the turquoise color, how you like to call it. And the buttons here on the upside, they are going a little bit fading with the color. So that's also an issue that I had with the Charge 3. And it also has to do with the material, of course. It's some kind of soft plastic material. But it's taking the color of anything that is dirty. So the buttons, they're okay, but still a little the same issue as with the Charge 3. So the passive radiators, in a first impression I was okay with it, and I am. The problem with other YouTubers like Speakertonio or Otto, they had the black one. And with the black one, the glossy passive radiators, I didn't like that so much. So when I ordered this one, because the price was just insane low, I was thinking I will not take the black one, I will try another color. So the color that I also tried out with the Charge 3. And I will see how the problem is, or is it really a problem. So with this color, it isn't very much recognizable if the passive radiators are dirty or have been some scratches on it. With the black one, it's just more like a reflection on it. And with this one, you have a reflection from the light, for example, but it isn't that noticeable as with the other color, because the other color is also the one that I tested out in the store. But this one I didn't found in a store that moment, so I just bought it with no idea if it would be worse or better. I prefer this color with the passive radiators. They look okay, and actually I like it on this color, but on the black one I don't like it. So the overall build is okay. This can be annoying for some people. You can get it off so very easily. I will not do it, for example. It's just taking the rope underneath it, and then you have it off. It's very easy. It's like within a minute. So without it, it looks like actually almost Charge 3 or a Flip 3, but it's a little bit larger than a Flip 3 and also a little bit heavier. The sound's also a little bit different. The battery life, I would say it's okay. Like you can really reach more than 8 hours of playtime, but that's really with 70% volume, and the speaker isn't as loud as the Charge 3 was, so you have to also pump it up to 70% to get a very nice level of sound. And you really feel that the battery is going then around 6 till 7 hours. So it's okay, but it's way far from the 12 hours, of course. The overall sound quality, it's okay. The treble, you have some treble boost. More people have complained about it. I find it actually sounding okay or very great. But the problem with the treble boost is when you put it on 100% volume, of course it's going to distort a bit. I will show you guys a number now. It has been done in a normal mode, so not in a low frequency mode. I've done it with purpose because I already have some videos on my channel with the low frequency mode. I will put some links here down in the description. The difference between the low frequency mode and the normal is actually really the treble. The bass is not really like improving, because yeah, the drivers, of course, they move a little bit more, but not as with the Charge 3 that you really hear more bass. It's just like more pushing the air and it isn't doing much more. So I prefer the normal mode, yeah, for the oval okay sound. But yeah, if you really are annoyed by the treble boost, you can use low frequency mode till about 60-70% volume or 80, depending on the songs. Because if you do it higher, some people don't say you will break your speaker, but I know it because my Charge 3 broke and some idiot on YouTube is saying that it isn't happening. He is like stupid as fuck. But yeah, the speaker can break if you put it too high on volume. So I recommend to not do it actually higher than 70 or 80%, really depending on the music you're listening. So if you listen to music with many bass, don't push it too hard. So I will show you guys now a small example from the normal mode and I will go back with you guys. So now that you guys have heard the sound test, or yeah, the small sound comparison, yeah, you really can hear how the sound is. And really the treble boost is yeah, annoying, yeah, higher than 90% volume. But under it, it's pretty nice. It sounds yeah, a little bit clear to call it like that. But the bass isn't very much there. It has a very flat profile. Also depending where you use the speaker. So if you are in a room with yeah, more like very well acoustic, yeah, you can hear the bass a little bit better, but overall the bass is yeah, I would say average. The mids are the same. It's really the treble boost. It makes sometimes very nice with some old songs, but with new songs that have been already pushed up with yeah, the higher quality, it can be annoying, the treble boost. So keep that in mind. Overall, I think the speaker is very well built and I can't really complain about anything. There's only one thing I can complain, and that is, yeah, I would say the Bluetooth is sometimes a little bit annoying. Sometimes it works, sometimes it has some small issue with connecting some devices. So with my OnePlus 5, it connects directly. With my Mi Box, so the TV box, it connects also directly. But with a Windows laptop or with a PC, it's really very slow, and also with Apple devices. I don't know where that issue is coming from. I hope they maybe fix it with yeah, a firmware update, maybe this year or not. But that is really an issue with using the Bluetooth with different kind of devices. Because yeah, if you have friends with you and they want to connect it and they have an iPhone, for example, it could be a problem. Maybe it's also only my unit, but the connection with Android is a little bit faster. And normally it's the opposite way. So very strange. I want to thank you guys for watching to this small video. And make sure to be subscribed and see more videos about technology or Bluetooth devices. Bye. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me. Say boy, let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and